Never knew how many lives would be touched and reminded of God's grace. I never read the scripture today, and I'm going to read the scripture now in preparation before we look into the message. Ezekiel 47. Ezekiel is a powerful prophetic book. And the more I delve into this book, the more I love it. It is so deep, what God brought to Ezekiel. And please listen to the word of God, Ezekiel 47, reading from verse 1 till verse 12. Ezekiel 47, verse 1. Then he brought me back to the door of the temple, and behold, water was issuing from below the threshold of the temple, toward the east, for the temple faced east. The water was flowing down from below the south end of the threshold of the temple, south of the altar. Then he brought me out by the way of the north gate, and led me around on the outside to the outer gate that faces toward the east. And behold, the water was trickling out on the south side. Verse 3, going on eastward with a measuring line in his hand, the man measured 1,000 cubits, and then led me through the water, and it was ankle deep. Again he measured 1,000, and led me through the water, and it was knee deep. Again he measured 1,000, and led me through the water, and it was waist deep. And again he measured 1,000, and it was a river that I could not pass through, for the water had risen. It was deep enough to swim in, a river that could not be passed through. And he said to me, Son of man, have you seen this? Then he led me back to the bank of the river. As I went back, I saw on the bank of the river very many trees on one side and on the other. And he said to me, this water flows towards the eastern region and goes down into Arabah and enters the sea. When the water flows into the sea, the water will become fresh. And whenever the river goes, and wherever the river goes, every living creature that swarms will live, and there will be very many fish. For this water goes there, that the waters of the sea may become fresh. So everything will live where the river goes. Fishermen will stand beside the sea. From Engedi to Eneglaim, it'll be a place for the spreading of nets. Its fish will be very many kinds, like the fish of the great sea. But its swamps and the marshes will not become fresh. They have to be left for salt. And on the banks, on the both sides of the river, there will grow all kinds of trees for food. Their leaves will not wither, nor their fruit fall, but they will bear fresh fruit every month, because the water for them flows from the sanctuary. Their fruit will be for food, and their leaves for healing. Please take note of God's word. Now we're going to turn to Revelation, which will be the focus of our message today. Revelation chapter 22. Some of you are saying, thank God, we're coming to the end. And I say to you, after studying the book of Revelation, it is one of the most powerful books in the Bible. And Satan will do everything to keep you away from this book. Because in it, the judgment for Satan and the demonic entities and the unbelieving world are going to be judged. And Christ is exalted to the highest place. So let me read Revelation 22. Think about what I just read in Ezekiel 47. Now I'm reading Revelation 22, verse 1. This is the very end. The new heavens and the new earth have come down. But I want you to see what is even happening in this new heavens and new earth, the new Jerusalem that came out of heaven. Revelation 22, verse 1. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright white as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb. Through the middle of the street of the city also, on either side of the river, the tree of life with its 12 kinds of fruits, yielding its fruit each month. The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. Folks, do you see how consistent God's word is? From prophecy to reality. Verse 3. No longer will there be anything accursed, but the throne of God and the Lamb will be in it, and his servants will worship him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads, and night will be no more. They will need no light of lamp or sun, for the Lord God will be their light, and they will reign forever and ever. Okay? The consistency of God's word sometimes is just overwhelming. The river of life. It begins with them. The angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb. Now he's saying, you know, we thought everything was going to be perfect in the new Jerusalem, in the new heavens and the new earth. Let me just show you. First thing I want you to understand, the water of life. Jesus Christ our Lord. Remember Jesus said that he is the water of life. Remember what he promised the Samaritan woman? If you drink of this water I give you, you will what? Never thirst again. We come first to the river of life. It's a river of heaven. Did you notice that? They that drink of it must drink immortality and love. It is the river of God. What is your connection to Jesus Christ today? Oh yeah, he saved me, he died on the cross to save me so that I don't go to hell. Is that all your connection? Do you remember his promise, I'll never leave you nor forsake you? Do you know in heaven you're going to be more united with Jesus Christ than you are even today? You see, it's a river of heaven. And I just want you to put that thought in the back of your mind. It's a river of grace. It flows from the throne of the Lamb. And everything that has connection with the Lamb is necessary of grace. That river, as it flows, it is showing God's grace, the unmerited favor that you and I have received. Not because of the good things we have done, but because Christ died on Calvary's cross and you came and bowed to that cross and accepted the gift from heaven, Jesus Christ. It's a river of power. You know how our world fights for power. It's not only in the church people fight for power, it's in politics, it's in workplace, it's in the home. We are power hungry people. Because when sin entered, it took the power that God had given to men and he gave it to Satan. And ever since we've been struggling to have that power. It's amazing to see the struggle of power in relationships, whether it is in a family or a church or any other place. But here, it's a river of power. Because there and there only, we will receive the true power through Jesus Christ our Lord. Look what it says. It's a river of power. It comes from the throne of God. And therefore possessing the properties of that throne, it communicates power into the soul of everyone that drinks or even that walks along its banks. The power and authority of God are in it, for it issues from the fountainhead of the universal power. You see, in the world today, people are involved in witchcraft and all that. What are they looking for? Power. And they get this raw power from the demonic world. And it is very prevalent. In fact, I warned you as a church and I warn you again, there is a demonic spirit that's even spreading in the church of Jesus Christ. And if you don't know the word of God and you don't have the Holy Spirit, you will not even notice it. It's almost like it's seeped right under the carpet and we've missed it. Because the enemy is going to do his subtle work. So watch. And that's why in the book of Revelation, when all sin has been removed, when Satan has been put in his place, God will give us, will endure us with a whole new power. Do you know, as human beings, you and I don't have power to worship God because we are of flesh, we are of sin. It's only through the power of the Holy Spirit we're able to worship God. But do you know, in heaven, you're going to be given a whole new power. Because guess what? You are going to be in the very presence of Jesus Christ, God the Father, and the Holy Spirit. Think about that. That is what our heritage should be. That's what we should be striving for. It's also a river of purity. A pure river of water of life. Like the Lamb from whose throne it comes, who is without blemish, without spot. Like the city through which it flows, into which nothing that defileth shall enter, as it pours its heavenly waters on us, now it also purifies. People ask me, am I perfect? Can I ever be perfect? Yes, you will be. You're perfect now in Christ, because you know what? He took your sin. He imputed his righteousness to you and me. Yet in the flesh we struggle. We struggle with temptation, with everything that the flesh throws at us. But like Paul said, how can I conquer this which I'm unable to do in my own strength? Remember he cries up in Romans 7 and Romans 8, thanks be to God. Through Jesus Christ we are redeemed. You see, redeemed people need to live very differently from the people of the world. And yet it seems more and more the world is conquering and covering the church more than the church is able to conquer the world. So it's a river of purity, the water of life. It's a river of life. Because the word tells us, wheresoever the river comes, it gives life. I like the old King James version. Whosoever the river cometh, it quickeneth. Remember those words that your tongue had to roll in a certain way? It quickeneth. It gives life. I'm sorry, sometimes I do see us Christians this side of eternity looking so dead because we have not tapped into life. Because the Bible tells me in him, Jesus Christ was life. And this life was the light of men. Christ in me, the hope of glory. You see, folks, we are just not going to go from being debased in this world, from being kicked and pushed around this world to more torment. We're just not going to sit in heaven with our eyes folded and say, thank God I made it. Now what? You are going to be more active, more alive, and you are going to have life because the Son of God has given you that life. So, in the book of Revelation, we are given this picture, the river of life. You see, where water does not flow, guess what happens to that water? It becomes stagnant. You know why it is called the Dead Sea? Everything comes into it, nothing goes out. So there isn't fresh water flowing through it, so it becomes dead. Nothing can survive in the Dead Sea. The only place where my body full of lead can float. It's a river of purity. It's a river of life. Wheresoever the river cometh, it quickeneth. Take it from Ezekiel 47, verse 9. Each drop is life-giving. It contains everlasting life. For the spirit of life is in that river. And then it's also the river of brightness. A river of brightness. The words, clear as crystal, should be bright as crystal. The same word is in Revelation 22, verse 16. the bright and morning star. It is a river of splendor, divine and heavenly splendor. Do you realize that's only in the first verse in the book of Revelation? See how deep the word of God is? Isn't it sad that we get satisfied just with surface understanding? And when the enemy comes, he can kick us all over the world. But when you know that a time will come when Jesus will sit on the throne, our Lord and Savior, who died on Calvary's cross, who took your place, my place. The Bible says when we see him, we will see him how? Face to face. And do you know, it's only at this time that men can come and see the face of God. Sure, we saw the face of Jesus Christ as a man on earth. But now you'll be able to see his face in full glory. And when you see his face in full glory, you will see the face of the Father. Never before has man ever been able to see the face of God. And you and I have the privilege to do just that. Is it worth following Christ? Is it worth your heritage? So it's amazing to see the river of life, or the spiritual enjoyments of the heavenly life. The spiritual enjoyments of the heavenly life are abundant in their measure. He says, and he showed me pure river. You see, great cities were always built next to a river. I mean, you cannot come to New Brunswick and not realize where was Fredericton built? Where was St. John built? Because guess what? One of the main trades that was throughout New Brunswick was what? Cutting logs. When you go to Fundy Park, what do you see? There was a place where they had set a settlement because there was water there. They would cut the logs, float the logs off to the ship to be transported all over the world. The Bible gives us the picture that in heaven there's going to be the river of life. It's going to be flowing from the throne of God. Ezekiel says it prophetically in Ezekiel 47. The word is so consistent. How many of you ever knew that Revelation and Ezekiel are comparative? Because you see, God has already given us his word long before. And now he has firmed his word through the book of Revelation. So we see, you see the gospel, the spread of the gospel is like a river flowing. Did you ever notice that? What is the gospel, people? It's the good news. What else does the, we say it's good news. What else does the gospel do? It's what?
Sheds light.
Sheds light. What else? Is what?
The truth.
The truth. What else?
Teaches.
It teaches. The gospel brings life. You see, this river of life in Revelation 22 is like the gospel that's going to be flowing constantly, because it's going to come from Jesus Christ our Lord, from the throne. That's what the picture is given. Did you know Jerusalem was not built near a river? The only place that Jerusalem is close to is the Kidron River. It's a small trickling brook. And all the filth of the city of Israel went to the Kidron Valley, into the Kidron Brook. But now the new heavens and the new earth is going to have a river flowing from it. Not only amazing thought, but what a way to know. When I first came to Havelock, New Brunswick, then built the highway, I used to travel this road, going to my friends in Maine and beyond. And I would pass by here, looking at those two bridges and this water. And I used to say to myself, why I love to live here. There's something about water. I have great fear of water because I sink like lead. But I love being near water. What is God preparing you for, people? Because out of the throne will flow a river. Let me just, the river flowing from the great throne. The spiritual enjoyments of heaven are not scanty. On this river, the richest products will be born to glorify humanity. Remember, besides this river, and I'm not going to look at this week, we'll look at it maybe next week, God willing. Verse 22. Through the middle of the street of the city also, and on the other side of the river, the tree of life with its 12 kinds of fruit, yielding its fruit each month. The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. The spiritual enjoyments of heavenly life are pure in their nature. Pure, clear as crystal, the Bible tells us. The spiritual enjoyments of the heavenly life are invigorating in their energy. Water of life. Remember, you can go and buy little balls, they call it water. And what does it have in it? It's got something called electrolytes. Electrolytes. And it just helps you to kind of energize. Well, I wonder where they got the idea from. The Bible says you're going to have water of life. You may be lethargic today, but in heaven you're going to be energized by the truest power. The spiritual enjoyments of heavenly life eternally meets the needs of the human soul. See, the thirsty there have a river with which they can drink and with which they will never, it'll never be exhausted. You see, the divine gifts in heaven will be adapted to the requirements of our renewed and glorified natures. Thus, the soul will be made glad. The spiritual enjoyment of the heavenly life are the outcome of the sovereign mercy of God. Out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. And so all the spiritual enjoyments of heaven, in abundance, in purity, in life, in satisfaction, in perpetuity, will be the outcome of the sovereign grace of God as exercised through and manifested in Christ's work as our mediator. Could say a lot more. Exhaustless, universal, ever-flowing, restoring. One verse from the book of Revelation, the river of life. Take a moment and think about it. How we are trying to eke out enjoyment this side of eternity. Boy, look at the lengths we will go. Like a comedian was talking. He said they decided with some friends to jump out of a plane. He said the moment they went there, the first lady that looked at him said, "You're too fat." So they wouldn't let him on. So they went to another company. He said, so we went to this other place and they charged us $300. He said, the first guy came walking, he was just a tiny guy with a parachute. And he looked at me, he said, "You're too fat, I can take you up." He said, then they just hassled me up on the plane and I'm saying, "Where's my parachute?" So they were in the plane, seated, waiting. He said, the next thing they know, they get this guy, and they strap this guy, he was a tall guy, strapped him, and this guy had a parachute on, strapped him on his, got strapped on his back. And he said, "What is this?" He said, "Well, I'm the one who's going to guide you out of your jump." And he said, first they've told me I'm fat, then they add another weight. How quickly I'm going to hit the ground? He said, it was quite interesting. They jumped out of the plane. prematurely. He said, why would I ever do this to myself again? You see, we are looking for that ultimate experience, taking all kind of risks, and then there's an experience that God is going to give us that's going to be everlasting. Where there'll be no more pain, no more sorrow, no more sickness, no more death. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb. It'll be there for all eternity. And as I thought about the river of life, all it would put to my mind, here we call on the Lord, we pray to Him, we cry out to Him in distress, in sorrow, in sickness, even in death. In heaven, you never have to cry out to Him. See, the river of life is the direct connection Christ will have with us 24/7. And out of that river comes life with all its fullness. I'm not preparing to get to heaven. I'm preparing to be alive and living there with my Lord and Savior. You know, we say pray. Pray about all things. Pray without ceasing. But here we pray in spurts here and there. And then sometimes we're looking back and say, Lord, where are you? And His promise to us, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. In heaven, you never have to turn around and ask, where are you, Lord? He's always going to be with us. And that's why this new Jerusalem, the city of God, is going to be near a river of life that is constantly flowing towards us. I don't know what you're looking for. I don't know what way you're heading. But I do know, from the book of Revelation, God has promised me to be at a place where this river will constantly flow and fill me with life. And oh boy, that day, you don't have to worry about Pastor Peter being late, speaking too long. Hey, wait, Scott?
Sorry.
Or all those other things. Because guess what? We will be in His presence. And I don't have to tell you. If you're there, nobody has to tell you. You will know because He's going to be with us. I want to get there. I want to be filled. I want to be near the river of life because that is life. That's why Joel could write, in Him was life and the life was the light of men. Remember Jesus said, I've come that you may have
life
and have it how?
More abundantly.
It's going to be fulfilled in Revelation 22. Father, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your kindness. Would you prepare our hearts, our mind, our spirit for this great, wonderful day? Amidst all the struggles of the flesh this side of eternity, amidst all the failures that we endure, we know that He who began a good work in us will bring it to completion. Lord, here we are. Complete your work. Let it begin today. Let it begin even now. Father, help us to come and set our hearts before the Lord, our Savior and our King. If you're holding on to anything that would rob us to come to this place where there's going to be the river of life, help us, Lord. Open our eyes. Help us to turn away from the very thing that will hold us back. Help us to come to Jesus Christ, being held by nothing else but by His love and mercy. For this we thank you. This is the day you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.